Hey there, Aries. Welcome to your April 2022 general reading. Now, we are in the month or in the sign of Aries, which means this is the sign where you have a lot of energy simply because we are in your sign. Now, remember that Aries is the very first sign of the zodiac. And when you are always the first, if that makes sense, you probably feel, you know, there's a lot of stuff in my life that I have to sort out and figure out myself, which is a bit of a thing about you, Aries, that it is not your strength to ask for help. Something that is an imprint that you have as an Aries, and that is an imprint that you probably should try to override every now and then. Because nobody is supposed to figure stuff out alone. And on that note, it is also important to realize that the way Aries is positioned on what is called the ecliptic or the eclipse, where all the planets are going, because Aries is where it is, as the planets move, the sun and the moon both often visit the southern part of the constellation of Aries. And because the sun is the ruler of the day, and the moon is the ruler of the night, Aries, you are being recharged quite a lot as life continues. So please, 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 please learn to reach out. Really important, and understand that when you hit a low, energetically speaking, it will not be there forever, because energetically speaking, you're getting a lot of support. So, this is just what happens in your sign, and now we have a look at what happens in the months of April 2022 for the very sign of Aries. And what we will do is we will sort of look at the overall energy as it presents itself to you for the month of April, and then we will look into your emotional core. Let's see what's happening, with whatever can let whatever you must let go or ought to let go, or maybe love is coming in. So we look at this. And then we look at opportunities. And opportunities, for the most part, are things that sort of come in, or advice that can be given toward situations that normally do allow yourself to sustain yourself, if that makes sense, right? So anyway, let's just move right in here. For the month of Aries. For the month of Aries, what are we talking about? For the month of April, for Aries, you have the Kid Fox and the Groundhog. Now, I already started explaining that as Aries, you sometimes feel a bit alone and you have problems reaching out and figuring out stuff if it's really difficult because you're just not asking for help. Now, the reason why I probably said this is because of the overall energy for the month of April for the sign of Aries, because you have the Kid Fox and the Groundhog. So, while you are an old soul and very, very self-sufficient, the Kid Fox is the animal that sort of lives in the desert where there's very few opportunities and from where there's also no escape, if that makes sense. So, with regards to the symbolism here, because you have the Kid Fox and then you have the Groundhog as your overall energy. So what the guides are saying to you, you may feel quite a bit boxed in energetically in April. And what they're asking you to look at is, hence the Groundhog. You have probably all seen the movie Groundhog Day back in the day. What they're asking you is to understand, if you feel, I'm feeling boxed in, nothing is really happening, they're asking you to make sure that you understand that following patterns, following the same narrative that makes up your life, might have something to do with why you're feeling stuck. So it is time, this month, in your month, if that makes sense, in April of 2022, to reflect on, where am I in life? Does being here makes really any sense, right? And then make changes in that sector first. Now, because they're looking at patterns in your life, this may be mostly personal, which means while we are probably, obviously, when we look at opportunities, we might actually look at, you know, what sustains you financially and if there's anything to do with work. But what I'm getting here is is to understand that while this may be about work for you, to also reflect on your current situation in your home. How do I feel domestically, right? How much support do I have? All that kind of stuff. Or am I in a place where I'm just repeating myself and we're not going anywhere? So please, please, please be or look at your life holistically and assess all areas. Okay? So that was the overall energy for the month of April. Now we're looking into your emotional core. Let's see what's going on in April for the sign of Aries. Now, you have the Elk and the Sacred Tree. So what the guides are saying is with regard to how you feel emotionally, what's happening for you emotionally, the most important thing is, because you have the Elk, is to understand the calmer you deal with any emotional upset, the easier it actually is for you to get through it, right? So make sure that nobody makes you irate or nobody pisses you off enough for you to retaliate, if that makes sense. Really important to understand whatever comes to you, whatever upheaval is coming to you in April, being calm about it is the best way to deal with it. Also, since you have the Elk, you can see that the Elk has antlers. And every time you have an animal's antlers, you are quite protected. And because the Elk's antlers are sort of going sideways, what they're saying to you is, pay attention to how people speak to you, because that's part of this feeling upset. So it's not just what is being said, but how is it said and how the overall energy around you presents itself to you, and how you listen and how you feel generally people are communicating to you and with you. Ultimately, with regards to your emotions, you have the Sacred Tree. And this is some sort of a self-esteem thing here, where the guides are saying to you is, if you truly reflect and realize, you know what, I have been here for quite some time. My advice normally is sound. I don't talk a lot of bullshit, right? I know what I know. And so ultimately, because you have the Sacred Tree, what the guides are saying is, with regards to your emotional core, don't allow yourself to feel and be upset, and remember that you're quite connected to the bigger picture, as it were. And any battle, if that makes sense, that you go through or that you actually fight emotionally will not go on forever. Now, we looked at your overall energy with the Kid Fox and with the Groundhog. So the energy for Aries in the month of April, which is your birthday month of all things, for the most part at least, is not super high, which is why the guides are saying is, this is the time for you to reflect, right? So please, please, please reflect on your life, because only when you actually stop a little and really assess your life can changes come to you, right? So let's have a look at opportunities as they come to you this month. You are watching Thomas's Tarot readings, or Thomas's Tarot page, with myself, Thomas Janak. If you like my work, then please like, subscribe, and share widely. And if you want, you can now buy me a coffee on buymeacoffee.com/mediumthomas. That's buymeacoffee.com/mediumthomas. Now, you have the Hawk, and you have Totem, which means family. Now, with regards to opportunities, it is interesting here to see that they're not really talking about external opportunities. They're talking about opportunities easing any issues that you have with the family. So you have the Totem, which is your family card, right? Your flesh and blood family card, I should probably state here. And you have the Hawk. The first thing for Aries to do here, especially having the elk, where they're saying is just pay attention to how people are speaking, is to just go with the flow, right? So again, maybe you have people in your family or in your close, you know, family that don't quite get you, and that also advise from their point of view. And so dismiss what doesn't sit right with you, if that makes sense. It is not the easiest thing to do for Aries in the month of April 2022 when it comes to family members, family feuds, anything changes, any changes in the family, to be super vocal about it, because the hawk is using the upthrust of the air to glide. And that just means sorting stuff out in April may not go anywhere, right? So just go with the flow, right? Really important at all times to be flexible, actually, to stay flexible, right? And because of the hawk, the energy for this month with regards to sorting anything for and with family members is rather low, which means it will also be very likely a difficult month to sort a lot of things out, right? So this is just the opportunities that you have. So as you can see, they're not highlighting any major opportunities. Now remember, this is a general reading. It might not sit right with all of you, right? If that makes sense. But for the most part, Aries, what we got here for you is to understand that this is the month of reflection. This is the month of being calm. And this is the month of not giving in to any urges to set the record straight, if that makes sense, right? Because the energy of having proper conversations is not really a good energy to sort anything out this month, if that makes sense, right? So enjoy your birthday months, unless you were born, well, even if you were born at the end of March, right? Just enjoy your April, but understand that this is going to be a month for Aries where slowly does it, okay? No point trying to go for major things, because the energy just isn't conducive to reaching full potential this month for the sign of Aries. Okie dokie, that's all we got time for. See you next month.